and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Since I'm currently stuck in isolation, I wanted to spend this time working on a couple of goals that I sort of had this year. And one of my main goals that I wanted to do was start working on my health and well-being, which I talked a little bit about in the vlogs. I wanted to share my journey and all of the different techniques and things I learn and things that I do, because maybe it might be helpful for someone who is trying to do the same thing, or maybe something that I can look back on and use and have a look at all the experiences that I've had. I've been wanting to work on these sorts of things for a while, and I've intermittently worked on different things, but I think now that I'm stuck at home and there's nothing that I can do, I would like to actually put in more effort. So I'm really looking at the sort of physical, mental, spiritual well-being, how that can help. And really, what I want to do by doing this is working towards my best self. So what I mean by this is not how you physically look, but how you feel every day in your everyday life. So just a bit of background about me if you're interested, and so that you have a bit of an idea of where I'm coming from. I'm 26, married to the love of my life, which he will love hearing. And I'm a qualified teacher. I've been teaching in a primary school education for the last 3 or 4 years. I did a couple of years doing casual teaching and also working with special needs children, which was really rewarding. But what I found is I'm not suited to the classroom because I am a bit of an A-type personality and I don't know how to stop working. So if I'm not doing lesson plans or making new resources or blah, 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 I'm feeling guilty, like to the point where I was constantly not able to go outside because I was like, I need to be doing more work. How can I help these kids? So we moved and I went through a couple of different courses that I thought I might be interested in and have finally settled on graphic design. I'm just past the halfway mark for my graphic design, which is really exciting, and I'm finding that I just love it. I'm really, really enjoying it. In terms of why I actually need to work on myself a bit, I've had quite a few different illnesses and issues. I have bulging discs in my L4 and 5 in my lower spine, which has been a lot of an issue. I've also had glandular fever and Ross River fever, which was awful in my uni times and you never really recover from. And the, I guess, most recent and most difficult one was I had a DVT, a deep vein thrombosis, so a big blood clot in my shoulder, in the vein through there. And it turned out I had thoracic outlet syndrome, which is not very common. So then had to have a couple of different surgeries to fix that. So physically, I'm a little bit broken. Mentally, I'm a little bit anxious. And having this time to actually work on these things and try different resources and do things will be really good for me. So to keep myself accountable, I want to set a couple of different goals so that I can say exactly what I want to be achieving in the next 6 months to a year. So in terms of being physical, I want to find the right exercise for me, be exercising for pain as well as to help for my anxiety, which I think will be make a really big difference. Endorphins make you happy. And to help with a lot of the physical issues that I have, so my shoulder, my neck, my lower back, those sorts of things. So I want to increase flexibility and reduce pain. In terms of mental goals, I really want to become more resilient and have those sorts of mechanisms to help cope with different things that actually happen. And I want to be able to find more joy in my everyday life. Marty and I have lived such a blessed life, being able to travel, have the things that we want to have and do the things that we want to do. But I really want to get to a stage where in our everyday life, we feel really blessed and we feel really fulfilled. And then the last one that I want to work on is in regards to spirituality. And I know that this is considered a bit of a hippie topic to talk about, but I found a much deeper connection with spirituality and understanding what it actually means rather than just thinking it's religion or crystals or those sorts of things. when people talk about spirituality, they're really talking about your inner self, your most authentic self, helping others, having your own intuition, being able to meditate, being able to reflect, and having a better understanding of who you are as a person and what your values are. So I want to be able to become my most authentic self and make choices based on what I want and what I believe, rather than being influenced by other people or even what I think other people think that I should be doing. And as someone who's always wanted to be a teacher, I want to be in service of people. I want to be able to help others in a different capacity to the classroom, because obviously that didn't work well for me. So I'm looking forward to being able to see where that takes me and what that does. And maybe this is the start. So this weekend, I'm going to be a part of a Zoom session for the Mindful Collective, looking at self-care and different ways that we can do self-care, because I am 100% not a bath person. I don't relax in the bath. I just feel stressed and I'm like counting down the minutes until I can get out and do something. So I'm looking forward to finding the right thing for me. If you're interested in following me on my journey, I'm going to use an Instagram page, Catherine_O'Driscoll_, and share all of my tips and tricks and motivation and how it works for me and what actually works for me. So if you're interested, you can check me out over there. I'm also going to be posting on YouTube once or twice a week, depending on what's going on. And our next video will be the self-care workshop, so I can show you some of the ideas that they share with us and figure out which one is best for me. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.